Hello, I'm Mr. Anujan, a retired lecturer in mythology, teaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity, and Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. He came in 1469 and preached gospel for 150 years through five more lives to specialize the subject. And still the darkness could not be comprehended, because in India we have the kings and emperors of darkness, and then soul power had to be used to sort them out. And here I'm writing exposition of John 6 verse 62-69, holy gospel of our supernatural father Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., delivered by the First Anointed Christ, which in Punjabi we call Satguru, Jesus, according to St. John 6, verse 60-69. Now this gospel is for the twice born people. And first you should know how to become the once born, or the born of water. This body is flesh and soul, and this is the natural body. Holy Spirit is by the grace of our Father. Spirit of man is called common sense, and Spirit of God is called extraordinary sense. So that is by grace. So those who receive the Holy Spirit from our Father, they have two choices: to use that one for the benefit of humanity, in which it is a Holy Spirit, or you can use same Spirit to misuse it, to cheat people, fleece people, or to become rich in mammon. As you can see, the Jewish people in America, they control the mammon and media. So they are the sons of Satan. And that is why they are creating all this problem in the Middle East. Much more you can learn from your own heart. You don't need to read books, you know. So the twice born people don't read books. The once born people of flesh and soul only, they go to the college, study the dead letters, and vomit it out without understanding. We don't vomit out dead letters. We go deeper, because the gospel is buried under the parables. So here I'm going to do this John 6 verse 60 and 69. Many of the twice born brethren of Jesus, and not the once born disciples of the rabbis. Rabbis used to have disciples. The root of the word disciple is discipline. The rabbi used to discipline the natural boys by teaching them the moral of Moses. So their intake was between 12 to 16 years old, whereas Jesus' intake was around 25 to 30, who are grown up, you know, had some life experience of life. So disciple is a corruption by the Messianic Jews in the Bible. And so are the Lord. And who were listening said, this saying is hard. Who can accept it? Since Jesus knew that his brethren were murmuring. Remember, in Jesus we have one Father, and we are all brethren. And we exercise love called agape, unconditional love. Whereas the once born people, they exercise love called arrows, arrows of flesh. Twice born seed to serve God, they exercise love called filial love. And when you are one with God, as at Pentecost they were, they exercise love called storge love, storge. So all these words are explained in my Trinity, which you will find it in the at the bottom of the description of the video. And this is the very backbone of theology. So while listening, this saying is very hard. Who can accept it? Since Jesus knew that his brethren were murmuring about this, he said to them, "Does this shock you? What if you were to see the Son of Man ascending to where he was before with his supernatural Father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc.?" Now Jesus was not a prophet. Prophets are the whip master for the rabbis. They are those who are perfect in the moral laws. John the Baptist was a prophet. Elijah. My God is Yahweh. So that was concerned with this one, moral laws. And our supernatural Father is concerned with our soul, which has no flesh, no sin applied to them. So Jesus was this very Son of our supernatural Father, which is Elohim Allah Parbrahm, which is Spirit with capital S. And Jesus came with the Spirit with capital S, and same was with John the Baptist. And at Pentecost, when the Father rewarded the laborers of Jesus, they all possessed Holy Spirit with capital S. And Peter was once born, and his jump was great. He was very, very much intoxicated with the Holy Spirit. So, it is the Spirit that gives life. Spirit means common sense. Holy Spirit is common sense. And that you can use or misuse it. It is the Spirit that gives life and makes you capable of logical reasoning to brew logo, His word, while the flesh plus soul that makes the natural man is of no avail. The words I have spoken to you are Spirit. That means it is for those who are twice born of Holy Spirit and not for the once born people. Are of Spirit for the twice born people, and you attain eternal life called resurrection. But there are some of you who do not believe because they love mammon, money. And that was Judas Iscariot. He was thinking, "Hey, let him keep on talking. I am after money, you know." Jesus knew from the beginning the ones who would not believe because they love mammon and seek the praises of people like Judas Iscariot. Judas Iscariot was favorite in the temple, because he will tell them everything about Jesus. He was seeking the praises of the people rather than of God. So, Jesus knew from the beginning the ones who would not believe because they love mammon and seek the praises of people like Judas Iscariot. And the one who would betray him, that is, he was the one because he was a thief stealing money from the purse for his personal use, as he is a dog-collar priest in churches. They are Judas Iscariot in sheep's clothing. They are thieves. At the end of the month, they steal money from the church purse as their salaries, as if they are working for Mammon and not for God. So they are number one hypocrite. They are sweet spoken, because the once-born people, they like sugar-coated sermon. They don't like gospel truth. Gospel truth politicians don't like gospel truth. They give you deliberately sugar-coated sermon to attract people. And then sugar-coated sermon kill people in thousands and millions. Gospel gives you life. And you have the protection of our supernatural Father when you speak gospel. Those who give you sugar-coated sermon, they are sons of Satan. Satan doesn't give you protection. He wants to see that you die. And that is why the sugar-coated sermon gives you death. So, and he said, for this reason I have told you that no one can come to me unless it is granted him by my Father. That means unless Father be willing, nobody can know gospel. And nobody would be attracted to Father or is sealed to serve God. They are the, this one here, you know, I have the Trinity. And this will make clear here that these are the people, secular people, those who are sons of man, tribal people, John the Baptist. They come here. This is the field of John the Baptist. So he baptized them in the name of Abraham. And he baptized Jesus in the name of his heavenly Father, Yahweh. And then you become twice born, seeking our supernatural Father. Here they become sons of the natural Father. Here they become then sons of supernatural Father. And they get Holy Spirit. They get Spirit, and it is holy when you earn these treasures. And is it evil when you go for money, cheat people? So Judas Iscariot went here, he deceived Jesus. And Thomas went here, doubting Thomas, went for this, and the rest of them went for here. And this is called Eros, Agape, Filial love, and Storge love at Pentecost. Pentecost, they were awarded the very Spirit of God. Holy Spirit with capital S. They became the twin brethren of Christ Jesus. So those who are sealed to serve God, you know, they go. As a result of this, many of his once-born disciples returned to their former ways of life. They went to the temple priests. They go back to the temple priests and they bore the yoke which the temple priests put on rituals and other things, you know, prayer and fasting and all that is under the temple priest. In Christ Jesus, we do not pray or fast, because this is the temple of God and God lives inside you. In his temple, he's not living outside. But if you love money and cheat people, as the doctor or priest are doing, there God is out, Mammon is in. So they themselves are not men of God. How can they make you sons of Most High? So you have to be solitary. As a result of this, many of his once born disciples returned to their former way of life, or they went to the temple priest and no longer accompanied him. Jesus then said to the 12 inner circles of heart, remember when Jesus took them to the house of our Father, where he washed their feet, which the Pharisee Simon did not, but Mary Magdalene did. So he honored them by washing their feet, and the Judas Iscariot was thrown away before he started washing them. So there were 11 left. And the temple priest, they are the ruler, and Christ is the servant of servant. So then Jesus said to the 12 inner circles of heart, so before he start washing their feet, he took the outer garment off. Outer garment is this one. So he took the lemon into his heart, where he washed their feet. And you can see how much he loved them. Do you also want to, he told his laborer, you know, do you also want to leave? Or they were free to go in spirit. In spirit we don't bind. Spirit set you free, whether you are want to come to the Church of God, one fold, one shepherd, or you want to go to the other church, temple, where the wide road and wide gate. This one of Christ Jesus is narrow gate and narrow road that takes you to the house of our supernatural Father, which the 11 took. Judas Iscariot was thrown out because he loved Mammon. He liked the wide gate and wide road, praises of the people, temple people. Are they free or to go? Once upon Simon Peter, who enjoyed the very tasty food. Remember, Jesus feed 5,000 people, and he compared his food with that of manna, which Moses provided, or Yahweh provided, when they were repenting that they won't be unfaithful to Abraham anymore. So this was a very tasty food provided by Yahweh. Demiurge Yahweh answered him, Master, to whom shall we go? Because he was once born, he used to address Jesus as Lord or Master, you know. Twice born people, there's all the other 11, they addressed him as brother, but Peter addressed him Master and Lord, for he was once more. You have the words of eternal life, or you provide the living bread. His word, we have come to believe and are convinced that you are the Holy One of God. Now some of there is an alteration by the Messianic Jews, so you have to be careful, you know. And Lord, and this disciple word, they are introduced by the Messianic Jews. So our Father God blesses you.